I got in my car, he drove, and I hit him.
Yes. As I pulled up to the designated spot, whatever, the fact that she didn't see no harm in what she did was wrong. She could have took my life.
What's up, YouTube?
We're back with another video,
and today we're gonna be reacting to some more couples court, man. So far, I want to know. We want to know. You feel me? Charles held it down. So, yeah, let's see what bro talk about now. Don't let me down. For the most part, I'm gonna try to be here with it. And I ain't gonna pick until I get enough evidence to. I'm gonna pick, but let's see what bro talk about.
Ms. Snell, all right. You brought your boyfriend here because of broken promises, and you're asking this court for $2,400. Yes. Tell me about those broken promises.
Yes, Your Honor. Berg took advantage of me. He has cheated on me throughout the whole relationship.
She a CEO.
And yes, I have brought him here today to get my money back.
I did not take advantage of her. Cena has been trying to control the relationship with giving me gifts and giving me things and whatnot. I don't owe her anything.
How many years together?
Two.
2 years together?
Yes, sir.
And she's controlling it through gifts?
Through gifts.
I want you to control me through gifts.
Are they?
I got a list.
I got a list.
We'll talk after, but...
I didn't even notice that.
All right, tell me about this. How you control a man through gifts?
Well, I have taken Bird on helicopter rides. I have bought him jewelry, taken him out to dinner, everything. Anything that Bird has asked me for or needed, I have been there for Bird.
How did y'all meet?
I was working as a part-time job at a security firm. When I met him, we talked. He made me feel like I was in high school, like I had a smile from ear to ear. I remember one night we was working. I told him, I said, Bird, I want to do you dirty. He said, what?
Okay, wait. What made a girl jump off
that? Right, what?
The way he spoke to me, like his whole country accent, it just drove me crazy.
So he's got a smooth, kind of cool thing working over there. That's what it was.
So at that point, he told me to elaborate. So I was like, Bird, I just want to do you nasty in so many different ways. And from that point, one thing led to another.
It was attractive to him?
Man, of course it was attractive to him, like, but dang, you ain't have to expose all that to the court. Look at this.
They like, we wasn't expecting that response.
We want to know why you want some bread. You know, I'm trying to see who I'm riding with this time, but.
I still don't know yet.
Yeah.
This started off with Tracina bringing me snacks like chips, pops, juices, water.
It's true. The way to a man's heart.
Yeah. Through his stomach. Yeah.
Not no chips, though.
Drink.
Water. I want some steak.
Do me dirty. That's the path.
Woo!
Okay. Exactly. So at that point, I mean, we was in the front seat, in the back seat. We did whatever. It was to the point that we was racing down the expressway to meet at my house. Like,
okay, get to the point, Shorty.
Were y'all supposed to be guarding something?
Yeah, we supposed to be guarding the building.
So he not a CO no more. Something must happen. Because she's still a CO. She a correctional officer. He a home care aide or something like that. So what happened? That's what I want to know.
Y'all kicked the building to the curb.
No, we was watching. No,
okay, so what happens?
Pretty much, we was just friends with benefits after that.
So did it ever move, in your perspective, beyond friends with benefits?
No, because I told Cena that I wanted nothing with a relationship right now.
Okay. So, in your mind, did it move past friends with benefits?
Yes.
Okay.
Once we continued to do what we was doing, he kept on coming back, and that's when he told me, Cena, I don't have no problem to be with you. I said, so you telling me, when he bought me a bracelet, that I'm your woman? He said, this is what you want? I said, yeah, this is what I want when he bought me a bracelet.
I bought you the bracelet because that's what friends do anyway.
No, baby.
Friends sit back and look out.
If he verbally said, if you want to be together, we can be
together.
That's
what you want.
That's what you wanted, bro. Don't do that, bro. He capping. I'm going with the girl because that's what friends do anyway.
Friends sit back and look out for each other regardless.
No, baby. And the charms on there say I love you.
I'm on the girl's side.
The two that was on there was one was a heart and the other one said love.
No, it said I love you.
Okay.
All right, wait. I'm no Einstein, but if a man, preferably this one, gives me a bracelet that has a heart on it and a love on it, I'm gonna think he's not just talking to the people in the air, he's talking to me.
Mr. Bird, I mean, it's looking so far like you're in a relationship.
Really? Like I said, it was just out of the kindness of my heart.
It was not.
So were you ever in a relationship?
No.
Oh, okay.
In your mind, you're in a relationship because you got a bracelet that says heart and love.
I had a bracelet.
Where did this go wrong?
It went wrong when he had moved to his family house and he was sitting there on the floor. And I said, baby, ain't no man I mess with have to sleep on the floor. I will get you a bed. I tied a mattress to my car for this man. So we
She a real one, though.
2 hours it took me to get to his house.
You had
to hold the mattress like this to get on the expressway to his house.
She a real one.
For 2 hours?
For 2 hours. I'm holding it, driving like this.
So,
about to kill people. I wasn't none of his friends.
Okay, Mr. Bird, come on now. Bracelets with hearts on them. She's driving 2 hours of the mattress strapped to the top of her car for you.
Looking bad, Bird. I ain't gonna care. She sounded like she was a real one. And you talking about...
That's what friends do.
She's driving 2 hours of the mattress strapped to the top of her car for you.
Beautiful thing with that story she just gave.
So, I did.
That's a beautiful thing.
It is a beautiful thing. You know, because not a lot of women would do that.
The truth.
Do you know the kind of woman that would do that? One that's in a relationship.
Exactly.
All right. You have brought Mr. Bird here because you felt he was scamming you.
Yes.
And you are asking this court for $2,400.
Yes.
Please explain your lawsuit.
Why $2,400?
Okay, so Bird came to me because he had a bite previously. Okay. He lost his job. Once he lost his job, he could no longer make payments on the bike. He said, well, you know, if I found a bike, you know, you can go ahead and pay for it. And then when I get my taxes on February 28th, you're going to have your money. I said, okay, fine. He found the bike. We both went to the bank and got cash, and he had cash in his hand.
Do you have any proof that it was a loan other than him saying, I'm going to pay you back?
The promissory note, but he didn't sign it. He refused to sign it.
Do you have the promissory note?
Yes.
Would you get that, Rob, please?
Yes, Sean.
He refused to sign it.
So you drafted up a promissory note for him to sign.
Yes.
Because it was a $2,400 loan.
Yes.
He ain't signed it, though.
How did he talk you out of not signing this?
He said his word was his bond.
This is exactly what we tell people all the time. Get a promissory note. But we also say get it signed.
Yeah, you gotta get it signed, Shorty.
But your intent, very clearly, is to have it loan. This was not a gift.
No, it was not. And he knew that. And he said when he got his taxes, he was gonna give me my money back. 3 days before it was time for him to return my money, he gonna tell me that the IRS had took his taxes. I'm like, really, Bird? Really?
I ain't saying I'm riding with him, but you know they be tweaking.
Look, a TurboTax ad.
The IRS be tweaking sometime. They probably took his whole return.
They do be tweaking.
Did she tell you that this was a loan?
No.
What did she tell you?
She told me that she was going to help me get a bike, which she did. I told her myself that I would give her her money back.
That's why she got
However, as time went on, the IRS had held my check for a moment, and then they told me that I couldn't get it.
She said she would help you get a bike. You said, thank you, I will pay you back.
Huh. Right.
Okay, at that point, it looks like a loan.
Yeah, you admit
it is a loan.
Because you don't pay back gifts, that's a loan.
Looking bad, Bird.
When you decide that when they take your money, and you already told her that you gonna pay her back, and you find out you ain't getting your whole tax return, you can't just not... Like, oh, never mind.
Yeah,
you already told her you was
gonna
pay her back.
You tweaking, Bird.
Right. Regardless of what happened down the line, I mean, at that point, you've agreed to pay it back.
Yes, okay. At that point. But once the IRS situation happened, I just had to come forward and let her know I couldn't give it back to her right then and there.
And have you paid anything back?
No.
I haven't paid anything back because she withdrew from that. She sat back and told me, Bird, don't worry about it. Take it as a gift. I didn't wash my hands of it.
So, Ms. Snell, did you forgive this loan?
No.
Did this conversation happen?
No.
Anything close to this conversation?
No.
What did you tell him about his inability to...
I wanted my money.
Right. Well, he told you that he wasn't going to be able to pay you. What did you tell him?
He said, Sena. So, you know, I got my car note and things of that sort, so I just don't want to be broke. I said, Bert, you got to give me something. You have to give me something. Bert didn't try to give me anything.
Snail, you know that, dog. All right. Conversation.
But, Miss Snail, let me ask this.
All right, Bert.
If you're in a relationship, why are you loaning money to someone you're in a relationship with? Don't you just give it as a gift?
I took this man to Las Vegas. That was his gift. His clothes was his gift.
They're not married, though. Like,
she was very clear about what was a gift. A woman doesn't draw up a promisory note for a gift.
Straight up, though. I
want to know what you said when she handed this to you.
That's my first time seeing that.
You've never seen this before.
No.
All right, Bert. Oh
my so God. You didn't tell her, my word is my bond.
I did.
Huh. Exactly.
Okay, why did you tell her that?
Because at the time,
what do you mean he sound yes, like, my I was word supposed to be giving bond. Her money back. He sound like, take it for, like, take it. Basically, what I'm saying is, my promise to you, I'm going to pay you back. He, to me, it sounded like he did that so he didn't have to sign up, which you would call it.
He's saying he didn't know about it at all.
Yeah.
So but when does your bond kick in? Because you ain't paid her back.
I didn't have to after she told me I didn't have to pay it back.
All right, Bert.
Let me ask you something.
Yes.
If you find out he hasn't cheated, do you still want your money back?
Yes.
Yes. All right.
Do you want him back?
I love Bert. I love Bert with all my heart.
So that's a yes.
Yeah. I love her.
You want
he
the
ain't
dirty
gonna want
bird.
Her.
I want the dirty bird.
She's bogus.
Right. She, he ain't gonna want her back.
Bird was caught on his bike with another woman on that.
You seen a woman on a bike?
On your bike. It was the bike I bought.
All right, we gotta see how she know it was his bike, though. We gotta see how it was
yeah,
his bike.
Yeah, I was just gonna say.
Wait, just listen. Okay,
and okay, I sat there okay. And I seen him, and he hit the woman on the bike. So when I tried to follow him, he pulled off.
Mr.
Did.
Bird?
First of all, wasn't no woman on my bike.
All right.
There was no woman on my bike.
You've never given a woman a ride on your bike?
Not while I was talking to her, no.
Mm. Wait, while you was talking,
while you were talking to her? So...
What?
Because look, listen. First, she said she seen a woman on his bike. I'm thinking he giving her a ride, maybe she on the back. But he said, no, you seen a woman on a bike. Meaning he wasn't on the bike with her. Not, but she's so certain that's his. Cause,
no, but she had no. She said
wait.
There was no woman on my bike.
Mr. Bird.
Right.
So he it had to because she caught him and it was he wouldn't pull over. Go back and listen.
Okay. Listen.
First of all, wasn't no woman on my bike. All
right.
There was no woman on my bike.
You've never given a woman a ride on your bike?
Not while I was talking to her. No.
Okay. Well, you said while you were talking to her, so that's a relationship, right?
Exactly.
But did I not bring up the point?
Exactly.
All right. What other reasons do you have to believe that he was cheating?
Bird had became distant. Bird used to be at my house all the time. He had stopped calling me. You know, I had to almost pop up to his house, and then I had went to do this drug testing for this third job I had to pick up. So an infomercial came about, basically telling you had to put this app on your phone. So I put the app on my phone.
And you
okay,
put
what
your
is
child
the app and what did it do?
The app was a phone that was connected to my iPhone. So it gave me my own personal number. Well, so at that point, I'm texting him. So he responded back to the text. I was pretending like I was some lady named Lady K. So he's steady going back and forth. Because
okay,
of me.
So he's thinking this.
You have an app on your phone that gives you a different phone number.
Yes.
And so you're text using that phone number.
Yes. To contact him.
And you basically catfishing him.
Yes. This man been texting this woman back and forth, which was always me. I said, so are you in a relationship? He said, no, I'm only committed to my son. I said, oh, okay. I go to the liquor store. I met this pretty girl. I asked her, I need your voice. Because I have to sit here and, trying to figure out what's going on. My God, she's down for whatever.
This is what I'm talking about. This is what I understand. If you already caught him saying he ain't in no relationship, texting her, what you need the girl's voice for? Like, what you just need?
She probably wanted to see, like, if he would meet up with the person and not just, like, it's not all talk. Or for him, so he can't say that it wasn't him.
probably what it is. So he can't say that that's not him texting. Because she wouldn't be able to prove that.
You go and see it.
Now, this is what the girl say. All right. So she get on the phone.
You know, women stick together like that.
Yeah, so she
already knew what was going on.
She get on the phone. She's talking to him. And she was like, yeah, I'm in the charger and, you know, so on, so forth and all this. He said, okay, I'll meet you in 15 minutes. So I go across the street. I'm in the bushes. Like this. You
know, she in the bushes. She crazy.
He pulled up. I got in my car. He drove. And I hit him.
Okay, wait a minute.
Wait, she...
You caught him, though.
Wait, she said she hit the bike? Is that what she just
said? She said, I hit him?
Or...
I hit the bike?
When he came, he pulled up. I got in my car. He drove. And I hit him.
Okay, wait a minute. What? You are hiding in the bushes.
Yes.
Because you've gone straight CSI.
Yes.
And you've set up a sting operation.
Yes.
And he takes the fall and comes.
Yes.
Come on.
Mr. Bird, what you got?
Mr. Bird. Got that one dead in the bag. First of all, the way she texts, she used the same way that she texts me regularly.
So you recognize the words
that
she
way that she was texting, so I knew who it was. So basically, I started playing into her game, and I called 3 to 4 times at least.
Uh-huh.
And that
each time, she'll ignore the call by saying that she's driving or she's busy, she's doing this.
Typical cat.
All the time.
Stuff.
I want you to pick up for a reason because I know it's you. Stop playing. So when I got there, as I pulled up to the designated spot, whatever, I wasn't looking for a charger. I was looking for her.
Did you find her?
Yeah, clearly. She runs straight into me.
She hit the bike.
Yes.
So she ran over the bike.
Clearly, she runs straight into me.
Told his bike.
I'm on a
motorcycle.
What'd she
say? It's just the fact that she didn't.
Told his bike.
I'm on a motorcycle.
What did he say?
It's just the fact that she didn't see no harm in what she did was wrong.
Yeah, you tried to kill.
You're tearing up. That hurts you.
Yeah, I got a sign. She could have took my life.
Straight up, though.
When he told me that night, you tore up my bike. It wasn't
a... Fellas! When you peep some toxic stuff, bro, you got it. Because like he said, bro, she could have killed him being emotional. He got a whole son, bro. Well, don't cheat, first off. But, like, he could have killed this man. Like,
let's see what she about to say. She about to say something.
Hitting him off the motorcycle on some GTA stuff.
I was
wondering
if he had to be hospitalized or something.
Man, I would have took her to court.
All right, listen.
When he told me that night, you tore up my bike. It wasn't about his life. It wasn't about none of that.
His bike.
He kept on speaking on his bike. It was my bike.
But Ms. Snell, was he on the bike when you ran it?
No, he had got off and I hit it.
Right. Ms. Snell, you still have unanswered questions about whether he was cheating. So to get to the bottom of this, the court is going to call former special agent.
I mean, but he claimed that they were licensed polygraph examiner,
Mr. Kendall Scholl of Kendall Investigations. Ron, would you please escort Mr. Scholl into the courtroom?
Yes, Sean.
I mean, but he gotta admit that, well.
You know how crazy she gonna feel though if he went
in. Mr. Scholl, how are you today?
Good, thank you, Your Honor.
It's good to see you.
Good to see you.
Now, Mr. Bird has testified in court that he has not been with any other women. And you administered a polygraph examination for Mr. Bird. Is that correct?
Yes, I did, Your Honor.
All right.
Mr. Scholl, you asked, during your 2-year relationship with Ms. Snell, did you have sexual intercourse with any other woman? What was his response?
Your Honor, he said no.
What did the lie detector reveal?
Your Honor, the lie detector determined that he was being deceptive.
Come on, Bird.
Ms. Snell?
Yes.
How are you feeling?
I'm hurt.
Aww. Tell him how you're feeling.
Bird, you know I loved you from the bottom of my heart. Aww. From day one. It was nothing that you ever asked me for I wouldn't do for you. And you wrong.
You had a wife.
No. I'm so disappointed in you.
Mr. Scholl, you also asked him a question that will help us with the lawsuit. You asked, did you promise to pay Ms. Snell the $2,400 loan she gave you? Is that correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
And what was his answer?
He said yes.
Okay, so he admitted that he was going to pay her back the loan.
Yes, he did, Your Honor.
All right, well, with respect to the promissory note, all the evidence before the court, it appears that it was a loan. All of the indications are that you intended to pay that loan back. And so, based on that evidence, we are going to find in favor of Ms. Snell and order you to repay her the $2,400 for the cost of the bike.
Thank you.
How you get your bread, though? Like, when that happened, like, do they, like, take it out your check or, like, can't you just never just give it to them, even if you issue to, like, what? Y'all let me know what happened if you just don't pay it back. Like, I want to know that.
Mr. Bird, I mean, do you want to be in this relationship?
Not no more. It's better for me to let go.
Because you owe her money now?
Yeah. Bird got to get it together, man.
Real talk.
I don't know, though. I ain't here. Can I say
But if you think about it...
Can I say that was a dub? Because I did guess right. For some reason, it don't feel right. The boy just capping like...
But listen to this,
You better make us look good.
Listen to this. He promised that he'll give her the money for the bike.
Yeah.
But she went and destroyed the bike.
Like, right. You ran the bike over, so...
I mean, is she...
She looked like she was wife material till I heard that. She almost ran him off the bike. But I don't know. Sometimes that you play with somebody's feelings, you don't know what they're going to do. So, my message is, just don't be out here cheating, first off.
Don't be a cheater.
Like, just don't be cheating.
And
you won't get ran off of your bike like GTA. But yeah, with that being said, we finna get up out of here.
Let's stay safe. We out. Always put God first.
What she said.